أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم. We'll talk about a few topics today. First of all, Prophet Dawood alayhi salam, he says in his whispered prayers to Almighty Allah that God, who will be my companion in the heaven? Who will I be dwelling and living with in the heaven? So that is a desire. You want to know your place where you will be in the heaven. Allah says that your companion in the heaven would be that lady, for example. Now, he was expecting that if he is asking for who his companion would be in the heaven, maybe one of the prophets, maybe one of the ulama, one of the great scholars. That was his expectations. Allah says your companion in the heaven will be that lady. He says, can I see her, who she is? The address is given to Prophet Dawood, and he comes to that address and finds there's an ordinary lady. And then he says that I am Prophet Dawood. She got over happy that the Prophet has come to see her. He says, I had a wish and I asked the Almighty God who my companion would be in the heaven, and he gave me your address. The lady says, you definitely have come to the wrong place. Maybe it's someone else, not me. He says that definitely if Allah has sent me to this address, it is definitely you. What do you do? Says, nothing. I'm a housewife. I look after the house, after my husband, after my children. Nothing special I do. Prophet Dawood says, think, maybe there's something which is extremely beautiful and good in you that Allah has sent me to you. She says, I'm very patient, extremely patient. So for that reason, Allah sends Prophet Dawood to her place because of her patience. So being patient is one of those beautiful qualities that every one of us has to have. You need patience in doing your wajib. So you want to offer your prayers, you need patience, that you have to get that much time out of your schedule and then stand in taharat facing the qibla. For a few minutes you have to be away from everything that you were occupied in. So you need patience in doing the wajib. You need patience to put away the sins and the haram. So in this day and age that we are living in, there are so many sins that are around us. So we need patience to be away from the sins. There is so much of temptation, so much of attraction in haram. So I need patience. With patience, I can put that haram away. With patience, I can do the wajib. And also in the problems that we get and we see in this world, for example, what is happening in Palestine, people over there, they are suffering. They need patience to tolerate the pain. Other parts of the world, people, they are suffering. They are going through a very difficult time. In this COVID situation, in this pandemic, everyone is suffering. All that routine that you had before this COVID, you were traveling, you used to go and see and go schools and masjids and Husseinias, congregations, everything was there. And now everything is at a shutdown. So in this lockdown also, you need patience. So patience is that quality that Allah loves. And then when Prophet Dawood inquires that who will be my companion in the heaven, Allah sends him to a lady. And the lady, the quality that she had was, she was very much sabur, and that is patient. That is one. The second thing I wanted to talk today, it's about, we have abbreviations in Islam too, just like you have abbreviations in English. When you want to say New York City, you say NYC. Or you want to go to Vancouver, you say YVR. That is the abbreviation. And you've got loads of abbreviations for everything that you have. In Islam also, in the Arabic language also, we have some abbreviations. Now, what are these abbreviations? I'll give you three, four of them today, and then give you a little bit of an information about every one of these abbreviations, so you can have them in your mind and then recite it also whenever it is needed. One abbreviation is called Basmala. Basmala in Arabic means, it's the abbreviation of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So if you hear Basmala, it means Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So instead of writing the entire phrase Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Arabs, they say Basmala. That is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And there's another one, it's called Istiaza. That is A'udhu Billah Minash Shaitan ar-Rajim. So instead of writing the full form, they say Istiaza. A'udhu Billah Minash Shaitan ar-Rajim. There is another abbreviation, it's called Hawqala. Hawqala means La Hawla Wa La Quwwata Illa Billah Al-Aliyy Al-Azim. Or sometimes they call it Hawlaqa. Hawlaqa or Hawqala, both of them have been reported, and they use it for the abbreviation for La Hawla Wa La Quwwata Illa Billah Al-Aliyy Al-Azim. So these are some of the abbreviations that we have in Arabic, and there are many more, inshallah. On another occasion, we'll talk about that. Now, when do you use these statements? So Bismillah, you know that whenever you want to embark on a task, when you want to start something, you say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And every task that doesn't have a Bismillah in the starting of it, that task, it is incomplete. So you have to have Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim before whatever you do, if you want that task to be complete and perfect. And also this Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, there is a secret in it. There's a code word in it, and we don't know in which letter, where in this Bismillah. And with that code word, people like many of the prophets or many of these noble personalities, they used to perform miraculous tasks with this Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, because it has got the sir, or the secret, or the code word in it with which miraculous tasks they are performed. That is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Now, Hawqala, that is La Hawla Wa La Quwwata Illa Billah, it means there is no movement, there is no might, but that it is from Allah Tabaraka Wa Ta'ala, who is that Lord, who is mighty and who is wise. So everything that you see, it's by the command and by the might of the Almighty Allah. This victory that Mu'mineen in Palestine, the believers, the Muslims in Palestine, they got, that is by the command of God. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. So no movement, no might, but it is from Allah. Tabaraka wa ta'ala. He makes people strong with nothing in their hands. Because many a times you find that Allah makes His creation the soldiers for His men, for His believers. If you are sincere in the help that you want from the Almighty Allah, He also sincerely gives whatever you want. So people there, they stood in protection of a masjid, which is the holiest site on earth here that we have faith in. And that mosque belongs to the Almighty God, because when we say a mosque, the mosque, it's the house of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. So they were worshipping in the mosque, protecting and safeguarding the honor of the mosque. They were attacked. They defended, they stood, and Allah supported. That is hawqala, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Now sometimes in our communities, when the grandpa, he wants to tell off his grandchild, he says la hawla wa la quwwata. So that is, they don't know where to use it. So where do you use it? When you want to portray that everything that happens is by the intention and the command of God, there you say la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Not when you want to tell off someone, or when you are startled and stunned and astonished with someone. No, one of the other examples that I can mention over here is that in 1966, Imam Khomeini, his son, he was poisoned in Najaf by Saddam. Now the father, he has lost his son, and not an ordinary son, a son that is very qualified, very dignified, and there were so many hopes attached to the son. Now in the funeral of the son, the father, Imam Khomeini, he comes, just walks a few steps and says, repeats, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, and then comes and continues with his daily tasks that he with his work. So that is as a result of having faith in Allah. A person, whenever he is, he doesn't get depressed, he doesn't get stressed, he doesn't worry, because there's nothing to worry. Because there is the Almighty God who is there, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Now, someone who says this hawqala or this hawlaqa, by saying this la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, he has surrendered his tasks and his affairs to the Almighty Allah. So here it's that faith that he has. So first of all, basmala means bismillah ar-rahman ar-rahim. Hawqala or hawlaqa, it is the abbreviation for la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahil aliyyil azim. Now when you say la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, it means that there is no movement. That is from the sins that we do. When the Prophet was inquired, what does it mean, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah? The Prophet says that la hawla an ma'asiyatillah illa biquwwatillah. You cannot be safe, you cannot be protected from the sins of God but by the might of God. If I want to put away wrong sins, if there are, so I need help. So that help can be sought from Allah. So I need help from God to not commit a sin. I need help from God to perform a wajib. I need help from God to serve someone. I need help from God to be patient in all these calamities and the problems that pour down upon us. So when I say la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, I am asking Allah and I'm admitting that this is my faith, that I don't have anything on my own. Everything has been given to me by the Almighty God, and I need His protection, and He can only protect me. So la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah al-aliyy al-azim. So when I say that, I'm asking Allah that whatever I have here in this world, a little bit of a might I have, a little bit of a money wealth I have, a life that I have, that is also not mine. It has been given to me. So I keep on reminding myself all the time by this hawqala. That is by saying, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah al-aliyyil azim. That was a little bit about the abbreviations we have. Once again, basmala is the abbreviation for Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hawqala for la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah al-aliyyil azim. And then isti'aza means a'udhu billah min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Now, one of the other things that I'd like to talk a little bit, it's the prayers that we offer. In the prayers, we have the surahs that we recite. One of the surahs that is wajib to recite is Suratul Hamd. And hadith says that la salata illa bi fatihatil kitab. Without this Suratul Hamd, the prayer also, it is batil. So you need Suratul Hamd in your prayers. So Suratul Hamd, it is the first chapter in Quran. And when you recite Suratul Hamd in your prayers, you have to recite it with a Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. And then you don't say Ameen at the end of the prayer. So when we say you have to recite Quran and the surahs, it means a complete surah. A complete surah, it starts with a Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. And then you end the surah until the end. If Suratul Hamd, it's 7 verses, including the Bismillah, that Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar Rahmanir Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin, Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'een, Ihdina Sirat al Mustaqim, Sirat al Ladhina An'amta Alayhim, Ghayr al Maghdubi Alayhim, Wala Dhalin. This is the Suratul Hamd. So you have to recite it all the way until Walallin, and it has to be with a Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. So reciting surahs in prayers without Bismillah, that will make the salat batil. So you need Bismillah. Now never recite Ameen after Suratul Hamd. If someone does that, that will make his namaz batil as well. So it's only the 7 ayat as they were revealed upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Suratul Hamd is such important that the Prophet, he says, if you recite Suratul Hamd once, you get the sawab of reciting 2/3 of the Holy Quran. In another statement, he says that you get the reward of reciting 1 complete Quran by 1 Suratul Hamd. And again, Imam As-Sadiq alayhi salam, he says that this Suratul Hamd, it is so powerful. And if we knew the meaning of this surah, and then he says, if you recite this Suratul Hamd on someone who has passed away, says if he comes back to life, there's nothing to be astonished. Because that surah, it is that powerful, it can do that. Now the reason why it doesn't happen when we recite, it's because we are weak people, and also that beauty or that secret that has to be given to us hasn't been given to us, as a result of which it doesn't have that effect. Hadith says that when you recite, when you go by someone who is ill, recite Suratul Hamd 7 times. Now this Suratul Hamd, if it is recited on a dead and if he is brought back to life, nothing amazing. Imam As-Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam, he says that. Now this is a Hadith al-Qudsi. If you remember, we talked about Hadith al-Qudsi. It means it is the word of Allah to any one of the prophets. So if it was specifically to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, and it was the Quran that was revealed unto him, which is again Hadith al-Qudsi. So to other prophets also, Allah had his word. He spoke to other prophets. So all of that has been recorded and registered as Hadith al-Qudsi. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he says that when you stand in worship and when you recite Suratul Hamd, this Suratul Hamd, it is between me and my servant. Half for me, half for him. So he says that I've distributed this salat between me and my servant in half and half, half for me, half for him. And then he says, when you say in your prayers, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, the Almighty Allah, he says, my servant, he remembered me. When he says, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, for example, I said, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, my prayers started. Allah says, my servant, he remembered me. And when I say, Alhamdulillah, here the Almighty says that my servant, he praised me. He lauded me, he praised me. And then that is the meaning of Sami'a Allahu liman hamida. Sami'a Allah liman hamida. When you rise from your ruku, you say Sami'a Allah liman hamida, that Allah, He heard. To whom all this praise belongs, that I was in my ruku, I said Subhanallah, now I stood up, I say Sami'a Allah liman hamida, that is Allah. To whom all the praise belongs, He heard me. Sami'a, He heard me. Allah says, the moment you say Alhamdulillah, the Almighty, He says that my servant, He praised me, He lauded me. And I heard what He said. Now when I say in my prayers, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, so I said Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, and now Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. The Almighty says that my servant, He exalted me. And the moment I say in my prayers, Maliki Yawmiddin, that Allah is the owner of the day of reward, here He says that my servant, He honored me, and my servant, He has surrendered unto me. And when He says, Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in, it means that only You do I worship and only You I seek help from. So that is Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. When I say that in my prayers, Allah says, this is for my servant, and my servant, He can ask me for whatever He wants. Only we haven't gone down to ruku yet. We have just started the prayers, and only for that Suratul Hamd that we recited halfway through, we said Maliki Yawmiddin, the Almighty, He says that my servant, He honored me, and my servant, He has surrendered unto me. And when I say Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in, You alone do I worship, do we worship, and from You alone do we seek help from. Allah says, this is between me and my servant. And when He says, Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, guide us on the right path, the Almighty, He says, this is for my servant, and my servant, whatever you want, you can ask me and I will give you. See, we have just completed the recitation, not even completed, halfway through. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. And then He says that you be loyal to me, I will be loyal to you. You be obedient to me and I will also be loyal to you. So this Suratul Hamd, it is that beautiful, very powerful, that you know the meaning of Suratul Hamd when you recite in your prayers. Wa subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun, wa salamun ala al mursaleen, walhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajjil farajahum.